Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today's topic of discussion is Docker. So what is a Docker and why is it needed? How is it different from the traditional virtual machine which we have been using for a long time? So if you go to the official documentation, Docker is an open source tool or a technology which allows an application developer to bundle the application code with all the required dependencies and libraries into a single box. Okay, which will work in every environment. Basically, the box which they package their application into with all the required libraries and dependencies, Docker termed them as a container. Okay, so we will discuss it more, the container and the VMs. Then what is a container? Okay, so we have discussed right now, Docker provides a tool to package our application and the required libraries or dependencies into a container. Okay, so what is a container basically? So let's say you have an application, okay, you are building an application which has a backend as well as a front end, and you have your Spring application and you are using Angular as the front end. Okay, so and that application is also having some sort of libraries or Python libraries which is doing some string searching or text searching kind of thing. Okay, so in that scenario, what all the dependencies your application will be having? Your application should have, the system wherein you are running, going to run your application, that system should have Java, JDK installed, then Node.js installed, because Angular also needs to be installed and Python also needs to be installed. Then only your application as a whole will work, right? So the one way of doing it is by installing all these dependencies into a server. Maybe basically a virtual machine, and then deploying your application code there, and then your application can run and the user can access it. The other way of doing it is you can create a container, okay, and that container will have everything an application requires, like the dependencies which on which application rely upon to run basically those dependencies, for example here Java, JDK, Python, Angular, Node. Okay, and also the source code of that application. So all of it, if bundled into a single box, and that box can be termed as a container, then with the help of Docker, we can actually spin that container up, and all the OS level dependencies which is required by the container will be provided by Docker engine. So we don't have to worry about which operating system that container should have, because so later on we will see how virtual machines are different from containers, then we'll be able to know that. There is no guest operating system required for each and every container. It can rely upon the host operating system of a server. Okay, so container is basically all the libraries and the code dependencies and the code itself bundled into a single package, basically a box, or you can say a container. Okay, so how container is different from VMs? So for that, to understand that, let's first go through the core stacks of VMs, how VM is actually stacked up, and how what is the core dependencies or core components of a VM. Okay, so at the very basic level, a virtual machine is comprised of, there should be an infrastructure basically, right? There should be a hardware or any server which has been provided by any cloud company. Let's say for example AWS is providing you a server, so those kind of infrastructure is the base. We need to have that. On top of that, we need to have a host operating system. Then on top of that, there will be a hypervisor, okay, and this hypervisor job is to actually use the components of infrastructure and operating system and to provide the resources which is needed by or which is required to create virtual machines, right? So this hypervisor actually uses the infrastructure and operating system to actually create multiple virtual machines, and each virtual machine can have their own operating system. That's why we have mentioned guest operating system. So let's say in this scenario we have four virtual machines, so the four virtual machines will have their own operating system, okay, and that can be different from each of the virtual machines. On top of that, those virtual machines will have all those dependencies installed. So as we saw earlier, in the container, if your application is dependent on JDK, Node.js, Angular and Python, then all the four dependencies should be installed in the virtual machines on which you are going to actually deploy your application, right? Because the application depended on these four dependencies. So this bin and library will be those dependencies which needs to be installed into the virtual machines. Then on top of that, you will deploy your application, the code of your application. This is how a virtual machine is set up, right? So each of the virtual machine, as you can see here, is having their own guest operating system, which is a huge resource. I mean, they are taking up huge space because you know the operating system size is huge, and whenever this virtual machine gets started or spinned up, it actually takes a lot of time to boot up because of the huge space this operating system consumes. Okay, so how Docker actually is lightweight than virtual machines? In Docker also, we have the same infrastructure. It can be any physical server or any server provided by, let's say, Amazon EC2 or any cloud native platform. Then we have on top of that an operating system. Let's say the most popular is Linux, so maybe Linux operating system. But here's the trick: on top of this Linux operating system or any operating system, we'll have a Docker daemon, okay, or Docker engine running basically installed in that operating system. So that and the job of hypervisor in virtual machine was to make these use these resources and create each and every virtual machines. But here in Docker containers, what Docker daemon will do, it will make use of the host operating system, okay. And instead of creating a different operating system for each and every container, it will just provide the capability of operating system to the container whenever they required. Okay, so instead of a guest operating system, the containers will be having their own dependencies, set of dependencies. So the dependency related to the application will be installed. Then the application code will be there present, right? So all these two, app one and bin and libraries, both of them are bundled in a file which is known as a Docker file, and the Docker file is used to create a Docker image. So your image is basically a blueprint of what your container should have. Okay, it's not in a runnable condition right now. It's just an outline or a blueprint that whenever you will build your container, this should be the dependencies which will be a part of your container. Okay, so those containers will require an operating system capabilities, right, to run those, to install those dependencies. So that will be provided by the Docker daemon using the host operating system on which the Docker is installed. So all the capabilities of operating system will be provided by Docker daemon. So this is how virtual machines is different than a Docker container. Case as compared to virtual machines, Docker containers are lightweight. They are very easily spun up. They take milliseconds time to actually boot up and starts working, rather than the virtual machine which takes up time to boot up and then reconfigure itself and then the applications are usable. Okay, so this is what we have actually collated from the official documentation of Docker Hub, that the virtual machines are basically an abstraction of physical hardware. Okay, so that they make use of one huge server and they tune it, they make use of their resources and they convert and to they split it into multiple smaller servers, each having their own operating system, right? Which is actually the culprit of having the slowness in the booting up of time. Instead, the Docker containers, on the other hand, is abstraction on the app layer. Okay, so it packages the dependencies and code all together. So multiple containers can run on a single machine. They share the same host operating system kernel. They don't have their own operating system installed for each and every container, and that's why they are less space consuming than VMs, and they are easy to boot up as compared to the virtual machines. So by now we have a fair idea on what virtual machines are and what Docker containers are, and why Docker containers are lightweight as compared to the virtual machines. So what we will see now is an analogy that how Docker containers are different from virtual machines. So by looking on this image, what we can observe is that there are multiple smaller ships which are like stacked upon a base ship, which is a bigger one. Okay, so the shipping capability, right, the engine and the fuel is consumed of the bigger ship. So the shipping capabilities are being used of a bigger ship, which is at the base, right, which is carrying over this stack of smaller ships. The smaller ships are not being used actively. They are only being used to stack upon the things which are actually present inside them. So think of it as each and every virtual machines, right? So each virtual machine is having their own guest operating system, and likewise in this particular example, the each of these smaller ships is having their own engine, their own fuel source, and they can easily be like deployed and they will be working as expected. Okay, so because they don't have a direct dependencies upon the base ship. But because of this overhead of having each and every ship of their own engine and all, they're actually not being used up, right? But if we see the next image, so this also has a bigger ship on the base, which is actually carrying over these many containers. So these are the shipping containers, right, which can have any commodity. Some containers can have cars, some container can have bikes, some containers can have edible items. So all of those containers are isolated from each other. None of the container is dependent upon a different container for the working of it. So all the containers are isolated, okay? So there will be no threat of violation of each and every container, okay? So no threat, no container can actually violate the other container. So each and every applications, if you can think of, will be running independently and isolated than each other. And also they don't have to have their own operating system, basically. If we like relate with the virtual machines or the previous picture where each and every boat have their own engines, likewise here, the containers don't have anything other than a free space wherein all the applications can and the dependencies can be put together, and they can make use of the base ship to actually run. Or containers don't have their own operating system, so they actually are cost effective as well. So this is the reason why the world is moving towards dockerizing the application, and we will see more of Docker commands and how to actually use Docker Hub registry. Till then.